Streams in the Desert. Volume 1. By Elizabeth Cowman. April 4. Elisha prayed, and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes, that he may see. 2 Kings 6:17. This is the prayer we need to pray for ourselves and for one another. Lord, open our eyes that we may see, for the world all around us, as well as around the prophet, is full of God's horses and chariots, waiting to carry us to places of glorious victory. And when our eyes are thus opened, we shall see in events of life, whether great or small, whether joyful or sad, a chariot for our souls. Everything that comes to us becomes a chariot the moment we treat it as such, and, on the other hand, even the smallest trial may be a juggernaut car to crush us into misery or despair if we consider it. It lies with each of us to choose which they shall be. It all depends, not upon what these events are, but upon how we take them. If we heed down under them, and let them roll over us and crush us, they become juggernaut cars, but if we climb up into them, as into a car of victory, and make them carry us triumphantly onward and upward, they become the chariots of God. Hannah Whittall Smith. The Lord cannot do much with a crushed soul, hence the adversary's attempt to push the Lord's people into despair and hopelessness over the condition of themselves, or of the church. It has often been said that a dispirited army goes forth to battle with the certainty of being beaten. We heard a missionary say recently that she had been invalided home purely because her spirit had fainted, with the consequence that her body sunk also. We need to understand more of these attacks of the enemy upon our spirits and how to resist them. If the enemy can dislodge us from our position, then he seeks to wear us out, Daniel 7:25, by a prolonged siege, so that at last we, out of sheer weakness, let go the cry of victory.